Every object-oriented language I can think of has a way to dynamically refer to the current object. In JavaScript, we use the keyword this, but as you and I both know, it can be pretty confusing at times. It doesn't always return the object you're expecting it to.
I would actually go so far as to say the parameter this is easily the most widely misunderstood aspect of the language, but it's actually pretty easy to use if you're thinking about it in the right way. So you'll notice I'm always very careful to refer to it as the parameter this, and that's because it behaves almost exactly like a normal parameter, with a couple of exceptions. Parameters are those words that we see between parentheses in a function definition. So there's really just two major differences between a regular parameter and the parameter this. The first is, you don't get to pick the name for the parameter this. It's always just going to be referred to as this. And the second is, you go about binding values to the parameter this a bit differently from how you bind values to other parameters. There's about 5 different ways, in fact, that you can do that, and we're going to examine them all in an upcoming lesson. But before we do, I'd like to just take a quick detour and look at the DevTools for a moment to examine a scenario you might find yourself in where you could start to ask the question, what is the parameter this going to be bound to in this case?